Bernie Miller's love for radio started when he delivered the newspaper to a radio station in Baltimore. He caught the attention of James Brown at WEBB, who asked Bernie to record a public service announcement. Bernie was only 15, and he was hooked.
I was a disembodied voice. I loved being behind the microphone and not being seen, and doing things, saying things in a certain way that would encourage people.
By his 20s, Bernie was living out his wildest radio dreams and working for a top three market in Chicago. He was swept up in a whirlwind of success, money, and glamour.
My lifestyle when I was in the radio world was fast lane. It's filled with a lot of drugs and a lot of groupies. A lot of money, too, can be made. And what you do with the money is one thing, and what you do with the groupies is another thing. It was, calling prostitutes and having people come over and, abusing drugs. And it's a dog-eat-dog world, and I had to get acclimated to it. And so when that happens, you use things to give you a boost. And I used cocaine to give me a boost. I used marijuana to relax. So it's such a vicious cycle.
Bernie's career skyrocketed. He was offered a job in New York, another top three market. During that time, he began to write music, with credits such as I Can't Stand the Rain, made famous by Ann Peebles and Tina Turner.
And I remember the royalty check that I got. It was like $19,000, and I'd never seen that much money at one time in my entire life. And I used every drop of it on drugs.
In 1987, Sony Records offered Bernie a position as VP of A&R. His roster included Michael Jackson, Luther Vandross, and others. His six-figure salary and million-dollar budget was all he thought he ever wanted. But one day, Bernie realized that it wasn't enough.
I woke up after being there for a year, and I said, is this it? I worked all these years to get here, and there's something missing. And there was a void in my life. And the night before, I knew I was watching an X-rated movie. I knew that, and I don't know if I rolled over on the remote control. I don't know what happened, but I woke up that morning, and I turned the TV on, and it was the 700 Club, and there was someone on there saying, there's someone who is struggling right now, and you are at a point in your life where you have made it, you've done all the things you wanted to do, but there's something that's missing. And I want to tell you that that something missing is Jesus. And he purposely put a Christ-shaped vacuum in your life. The next thing I knew, I was on my knees asking the Lord to come into my life and to save me. It was a total personality change, so to speak. I found myself not wanting to do the things that I used to do. I asked the Lord to take the taste of cigarettes and alcohol and any other substances out of my taste buds. And he did. And as I think about that moment, things has changed in my life.
After Bernie gave his life to Christ, he found it difficult to continue his work with the record label. The next year, Sony decided not to renew his contract. And Bernie Miller moved to Chattanooga to become a Christian radio announcer. Eventually, Bernie attended seminary and became a full-time pastor.
All the gold records and all the famous people that I've known mean nothing to me compared to the relationship that I found by watching the 700 Club. And anyone who's hurting, all you have to do is want Jesus. And when I was at the top of my career, didn't really need anything, but there was a void in my life. You have a lot of money, very successful, but all those things don't mean anything to you. At the end of the day, you still have a void in your life, and that void is a relationship with Jesus Christ. That's that same void that I had, and you won't be happy until you do what I did, and that is ask him to be your Lord and Savior.